ISUPK.
They try to tell me I can't win, all because of the skin I'm in. But then I look in the mirror again, and then we realize we better than them, we better than them.
They divided and they conquered my kin, but separated by the pigmentation of our skin. It's just that white supremacy agenda again. They want your mind in gold, cutting sugar cane, turning cotton gins. We left the plantation, then they pushed us into tenements. Police patrolling, hunting all my people like we're venison. The government's the criminals, they the real terrorists. Moving more coke than a Cuban watching pelicans. Selling all the dope, trying to kill us with the medicine. You a slave if you think that we're American. America was great before the pilgrims had a settlement. Trump gets in office, blacks uniting with the Mexicans. Black, Hispanic, Haitians, Jamaicans, we all relatives.
Shalom, Port of Spain. We are the ISUPK. Out of One West, 125th Street, part of New York, under commanding General Yohana. We teach the so-called blacks, so-called Hispanics, so-called Native Indian man, that you are from the lost 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. You are not African.
Right.
You are not Arab.
Right.
You are not Trinidadian.
That's right.
You are not Venezuelan.
That's right.
You are from the nation of Israel, black man.
That's right.
Trinidad was only 500 years old when Christopher Columbus came here. Here was not Trinidad. So your grandparents was a different race before they come here? How could you be a Trinidadian? Trinidad is the name of a place. It is not your race.
That's right.
Know your race, black man.
Right.
If you do not know where you come from, you do not know who you are.
That's right.
You do not know who is your enemy.
Right.
Your skin, black man, is your strength. Black, Hispanic, and Native Indian. Blacks, Hispanic, and Native Indians are one race of people.
That's right.
That is why we are the bottom of every economic ladder.
Good.
That is why the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians are in the ghetto.
That's right.
That is why we are on the streets. That is why black and black crime is so high.
Right.
It's because God's chosen people are at the bottom. So be proud to be a black man. Be proud to be a Hispanic man.
Right.
Be proud to be a Native Indian man. Because your skin color has power.
That's right.
Your skin color has strength, black man. Hispanic and Native Indian man. Love your black woman. Love your black children. Love your people first. Before you love the East Indian.
That's right.
Before you love the Chinese. Before you love the white man. Love your people first.
Good.
And we're going to show you here in this Bible that the Most High said to love your people first, black man.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
Black man, you is a holy people. Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. You are the salt of the earth.
That's right.
There is nothing good on this earth without a black, Hispanic, or Native Indian.
That's right.
If we were not here, the food would not be good.
Right.
The music would be trash.
Right.
The beauty of a woman is impeccable.
Right.
That's right.
Black, Hispanic, and Native Indian have the most beautiful women on the planet.
That's right.
There's no Chinese woman better than a black, Hispanic, and Native Indian. There's no Indian better than a black, Hispanic, and Native Indian.
That's right!
Love your people, black man. When you love your people first, then you will understand where your loyalty lies.
Right.
Because the loyalty of the Chinese is for the Chinese man. The loyalty for the East Indian is for the East Indian man. The loyalty for the white man is for the white man. Find your loyalty, black man, for your own people.
The Lord thy God had chosen thee to be a special people unto himself.
He has chosen you to be a special people to himself, black man. You are God's chosen people. Read.
Above all people.
Above what?
Above all people.
Above what?
Above all people.
No, this is the Bible telling the nation of Israel that you are above every single race on the face of the planet. These are not my words. This is in the Bible. Read.
That are upon the face of the earth.
So the Most High is telling you that black man, you are above. Hispanic man, you are above. Native Indian man, you are above every other race on the face of the earth.
Right.
There's nothing such as called equality. There's no equality on this planet. There's somebody above, there's somebody beneath.
Right.
There's somebody at the head, there's somebody at the tail.
Right.
Everybody can be in front. Everybody cannot be behind. There must be a leader. There must be a follower.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 7. The Lord did not send his love upon you, nor choose you, because you were more in numbers.
So the Most High chose us, not because we were plentiful, not because we look good, but he will tell you why.
In numbers than any people, for you were the fewest of all the people.
The children of Israel were the fewest of all the nations on the earth.
Verse 8. But because the Lord loved you.
Because what?
Because the Lord loved you.
The Most High did not love the East Indian. He didn't love the Chinese.
Right.
He didn't love the white man.
Right.
He didn't love the Arab man.
Right.
He loved Israel.
That's right. And because he will keep the oath which he has sworn unto your fathers, and the Lord brought you out with a mighty hand and redeemed you out of the house of bondmen, from the house of Pharaoh, king of Egypt.
So he brought the children of Israel out of Egypt. The Chinese wasn't in Egypt.
Right.
The East Indian wasn't in Egypt.
Right.
The white man wasn't in Egypt in slavery.
Right.
Only the children of Israel were in bondage.
That's right.
And the Most High said, only you that he loves, the nation of Israel. Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indian, you are one people. Who call you a nigger? Who call you a spick? Who call you a wetback? These other nations call you these names.
That's right.
You did not name yourself. They call us that because why? They are above. So the white man will call you a nigger. The Chinese will call you a nigger. This Indian will call you a nigger.
That's right.
But nigger is in the Bible. Nigger is right in the Bible.
That's
and
right.
We're going to show it in the Bible. We're going to prove to you today that the priests and the prophets and the Most High, the men who rode with Christ, they were called niggers.
That's right.
Because they were black men.
That's right.
According to the Bible.
Right. That's right.
Your pastor never tell you that. But they're going to say what? That nice. You can't say that. That go offend people. But being a black man, being a nigger, is the greatest thing on the face of the earth.
That's right. Right.
I am proud to be a black man.
That's right.
I am proud to be a nigger.
That's right.
Because the prophets of the Bible were called niggers.
That's right.
Right.
You are black color, black man, Hispanic, and Native Indian. You are the greatest thing on the face of the earth.
Acts chapter 13 and verse 1. Now there were in the church that was at Antioch certain prophets,
certain,
and teachers.
Certain what?
Prophets and teachers.
Certain prophets and teachers. These were the prophets of God in the Bible. Now if your pastor don't know, this is in Acts chapter 13 and verse 1. Your
what?
Pastor will never show you this.
What?
As Barnabas.
As who?
As Barnabas.
Go ahead.
And Simeon, that was called Niger.
That was called what?
Niger.
He was called Niger. For all who do not know, the word Niger is a Latin word. And do you know where they get Niger from? From the Latin word Niger. So they were calling the priests and the prophets of the Bible niggers in the Bible.
That's right.
Right. Right.
Nigger or Niger is just a word for black.
Right.
These were black men in the Bible.
And Lucius of Cyrene.
And who?
And Lucius of Cyrene.
What?
And Manaen, which had been brought up with Aaron, the Tetra, and Saul.
So today, black man, Hispanic man, native Indian man, we're going to let you know and understand that in your mind, we as a people suffer from colorism. Colorism is one of the greatest diseases in the black community.
Right.
Well, a light-skinned brother will watch a dark-skinned brother, and a light-skinned sister will watch a dark-skinned sister and say what? Watch he, watch she, watch the nigga. But you is a nigga too.
Right.
Nigga just means black.
Right.
The white man, the Chinese man, the East Indian man will make you hate your brother because why? He a little light skin or he a little dark skin. But it's time for us to come together, black man. Love your black sister.
Right.
Love your black brother.
That's
love
right.
Your people first. Because the Chinese love your people first. The Indian love his people first.
Right.
The white man love his people first.
That's
before
right.
You. That is why they own all the business. That is why they own the hardwares.
Right.
That is why they own the groceries. Because they love their people first.
Right.
That is why you in the ghettos and you in the slums. Because why? They make us hate each other.
Right.
That is why black on black crime is so serious. Because they make us hate each other.
That's right.
The book of Daniel, chapter 7 and verse 9. I beheld till the thrones were cast down, and the ancient of days did sit.
Now this is Daniel. Daniel is getting a vision. This vision Daniel is getting, he is describing the ancient of days. The ancient of days is the Most High God. God.
Whose garments was white as snow.
Now if he is a spirit, our spirits have on clothes. You have to have clothes, to a body to have clothes. Read.
And the hair of his head like the pure wool.
The hair on his head like pure wool. Only niggas have hair like pure wool.
That's right.
Every black man, Hispanic man, native Indian man, you are from the nation of Israel.
Right.
You are a nigga. Nigga just means black.
That's
it's
right.
A derivative from the word niger. What?
His sword was like a fiery flame. His throne was like a fiery flame.
His throne was like the fiery flame, black man. This is describing the Most High God.
And his wheels as burning fire.
And his wheels as burning fire. God.
Verse 10. His fiery stream issued and came forth from and before him. Thousands and thousands may stand unto him. And tens of thousands, time tens of thousands stood before him.
So we see the angels worshiping the Most High. Black man, Hispanic man, native Indian man, time to come back to your culture.
That's right.
This Bible is your culture.
That's right.
This Bible does not belong to the Chinese.
That's right.
Does not belong to the East Indian.
That's
does not belong
right.
to the white man. Does not belong to the Arab. This Bible belongs to the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and native Indians.
That's
go
right.
Go ahead.
The book of Daniel, chapter 10 and verse 5.
We're going to show you niggas in the Bible. Nigger just means black in Latin. Go ahead.
Then I lifted up my eyes, and I looked in, and behold, a certain man clothed in linen, whose loins were girded with fine gold of Euphrates.
Now a man is girded in fine gold. The man looking fly. The man looking good. The man looking wet. This is not no punk. This is not sexy Jesus. This is according to the scriptures.
Right.
What?
Verse 6. His body also was like the barrel.
His body is like what?
Like the barrel.
This is describing the body of a man. If a spirit has to have a body, and your body has to wear clothes. So this is given a description of a man. Go ahead.
And his face has the appearance of lightning.
And his face has the appearance of lightning. His face was fierce. This is the God. This is our King Yahweh Shai.
Right.
In the Bible, go ahead.
And his eyes as a lamp of fire.
His eyes like what?
The lamp of fire.
Go ahead.
And his arms and his feet like in the color to polished brass.
His arms and his feet like unto polished brass. Tell me, black man, what is the color of brass? A white man look like brass. Chinese man look like brass. Go ahead, read.
And the voice of his words, like the voice of multitudes.
Like the voice of what?
Of multitudes.
This was not sexy Jesus. There's no long blue eyes, blonde hair, homosexual Jesus. This is a fierce man.
Right.
The picture of Cesar Borgia is a homosexual picture that you have on your almanac in your house.
Right.
That was a pedophile and a rapist and a sodomite.
That's right.
That sexy Jesus in the Catholic Church. And all the pictures you have is a homosexual picture.
Right.
Well, today, black man, Hispanic and Native Indian man, you have to be proud to be a nigger. Nigger is from the word, Latin word, niger, which means black. I am a proud black man, Hispanic man, Native Indian man. Right. Be proud of who you are. Come together, black man, Hispanic and Native Indian man. Be proud to be a nigger. That is not a bad thing. White supremacy make you feel that it's bad. But I am proud of who I am because I love my brother in Seelots. I love my brother in John. I love my brother in Bakade and in the Congo and Charlotte Street. They call our people pests and cockroach. My black brother, that is what they call him. Three brothers get licked down in Port of Spain. I want to say, three less. When you go on social media and Facebook, who are you saying? The East Indian saying, three less. The Chinese man saying, good for them. The white man saying, done with them. The commissioner of police calling my brothers pests and cockroach. All these people in all these high places, nobody coming to help my brothers. Nobody helping my sisters. The Venezuelans come here, no help. They come here and what? To turn prostitutes. To turn what? For dog labor. But to pay you $100, $200 a day. All day you laboring. For what? But love yourself, black man.
Right.
Love your people first before you love anybody else. Love your black woman. Love your child. Love your Hispanic brothers. Love your Native Indian brothers.
The white man is the devil. Our history is evidence. Coons say I'm racist. By definition, I'm prejudiced. Got a right to be hesitant. As the African Methodists, we the endangered species. They'd rather protect the elephants. We the sons of God, like a seraphim. God chosen people from the Old and New Testament. Black power, Kwam Yasha Allah, black excellence. We your new rulers, bow down to your eminence.
They try to tell me I can't win, all because of the skin I'm in. But then I look in the mirror again, and then we realize we better than them, we better than them.
They try to make you think rich.
Why?
To make your whole life a big risk.
So what you do?
Commit a crime, get locked up, come home, can't get a job. Man, that shit just make you think bricks.
They trap you.
Ain't no way out of this poverty. Fuck being the prodigy, cause the world say you ain't shit. And then they give you religion. As soon as all that fails, they like to make you feel it ain't this, it's you. So what you do, you just can't get it right. Yeah, they like to say the truth hurts, but watch me take a life. And they like to keep you in darkness so you can't get the Christ. Not knowing like Jacob's sons, he is real light.
Get it?
So